Hello my dear students, in the previous class we discussed what is subtraction and which is the symbol for subtraction, right? So then tell me, what is subtraction? Take away a small number from big number is called subtraction, right? Then which is the symbol for subtraction? Minus, right? Minus is the symbol for subtraction. Have you remember? So in this class, let us solve some problems on subtraction. Now we have to subtract the numbers using this number line. Okay, the first problem is take away 5 from 9. We have to take away 5 from this 9 using this number line. Okay, for that first we have to count 9 points on this number line. Let us count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Right, from 0 to 9 I will draw line. Okay, to take away 5 from 9, we have to count 5 points back from this 9. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We reached at 4, right? The point at which we stop, that is the answer. Here we stopped at 4. So 4 is the answer for this problem. When we take away a 5 from 9, we get 4. That means 9 minus 5 is equal to 4. Okay, have you understood? Like this, we can subtract small number from big number using number line. Students, in this number line, they already draw the lines. Now we have to find out which numbers are used in subtraction. Let us find out. Here the line reaches from 0 to 7, right? So let's count 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 is the first number. Then how many points they count back from this 7? Let us count. 1, 2, 3. They count 3 points back from this 7. So 3 is the second number. And the point at which we stop, that is the answer, right? So here the point reaches at the end is 4, right? So 4 is the answer for this problem. When we subtract 3 from this 7, we get 4. Okay, have you understood, students? Dear students, here we have to fill the empty boxes. Okay, 7 minus 0. 7 minus 0, that is 7, and that 7 should be written here. Okay, 7 minus 6. We have to subtract 6 from this 7. Okay, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. How many fingers left? Only one, right? So 7 minus 6 is 1. Then 7 minus 2. We have to subtract 2 from this 7. 7, 1, 2. How many fingers left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right. So, 7 minus 2 is 5. Then, 7 minus 3. We have to subtract 3 from this 7. 7, remove 3 from this 7. 1, 2, 3. How many fingers left? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4. So, 7 minus 3 is 4. Then, 7 minus 1. We have to subtract 1 from this 7. 7, we have to remove 1, right? So, I will remove 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7 minus 1, that is 6. 6 should be written in this box. Then, 7 minus 4. 7, we have to remove 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many fingers left? 1, 2, 3. So, 7 minus 4 is 3. 7 minus 4, 3. Like this, we can fill this boxes. Students, we have to complete this chain. How? Let us see. 9 minus 2. 9, we have to remove 2 from this 9. 1, 2. How many fingers left? Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So, 9 minus 2 is 7, and that 7 should be written in this star. Okay? 7. Then, we have to subtract 1 from this 7. Okay? 7. From this 7, we have to remove 1. I will remove 1. How many fingers left? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, 7 minus 1 is 6. And we have to write 6 in this blank. 7 minus 1, 6. Now, we have to subtract this 3 from this 6. Okay. 6, we have to remove 3, 1, 2, 3. How many fingers left? 1, 2, 3. So, 6 minus 3 is 3. Then, we have to subtract 2 from this 3. 3 minus 2, that is 1. 1 should be written in this blank. And now we have to subtract 1 from this 1. 1 minus 1, how much? 1 minus 1, that is 0. 0 should be written in this blank. Finally, we get 0. Like this, we can complete this chain. Then, inverse method. What is the meaning of inverse? Inverse means opposite. In every addition, there are two subtraction. So, we can call subtraction is inverse method of addition. So, in mathematics, Opposite for addition is subtraction. Opposite for addition is subtraction. Let us see inverse method with example. Okay. 5 plus 4, that is 9. This means when we add 5 and 4, we get 9. Right. Now we will use the inverse operation for this equation. How? Let us see. When we subtract 4 from this answer, we will get 5. That means 9 minus 4 is equal to 5. And also 9 minus 5, we get 4. 9 minus 5, that is equal to 4. This is what we call inverse method. Let us see another example. 3 plus 6, that is equal to 9. Now we will use the inverse method for this equation. Okay, that means 9 minus 6, we get 3, and 9 minus 3, we get 6. Okay, this is what we called inverse method. This is the subtraction table. We have to subtract only small number from big number. Okay, let us subtract. 1 minus 0, that is 1. Right, and 2 minus 0, 2. 3 minus 0, 3. 4 minus 0, 4. 5 minus 0, that is 5. 1 minus 1, that is 0. 2 minus 1, 1. 3 minus 1, 2. 4 minus 1, that is 3. 5 minus 1, 4. Then 1 minus 2. Is this possible? 1 is small number, but this 2 is big number. Right? We have to subtract only small number from this big number. So 2 minus 1, that is 1. 2 minus 2, 0. 2 minus 3. Here 3 is big number and 2 is small number. So 3 minus 2, that is 1. 4 minus 2, 2. 5 minus 2, 3. Then 3 minus 1, 2. 3 minus 2, 1. 3 minus 3, that is 0. 3 minus 4. We cannot subtract 4 from this 3, right? So 4 minus 3, that is 1. Then 5 minus 3, 2. Like this, we can complete this table using subtraction operation. Have you understood, students? I hope you all are clear about today's class.